Hello and welcome to Traditional Painting the Digital Way. This is my crazy experiment to teach traditional painting techniques using digital painting programs. This is the final video in our old fence post painting series. In our last video, we added details to the grass and we added the small wildflowers. In this video, we're going to be finishing the picture up and we're going to be adding the large wildflowers and the old barbed wire and adding a few more details to the grass. If you're following along traditionally, be sure to check out part one of this video series where I have a list of all the paint and paint brushes and the canvases that I use to paint along traditionally. Okay, so we want to start here with adding the barbed wire. And the brush that I picked in Infinite Painter is the ribbon brush because it gives it a very thin, sort of a jagged look, which is what we want for old barbed wire. So we go ahead and we add in the top strand and we go ahead and make sure that it comes down into the grass. This is just to make it look like it's an old fence that has maybe fallen down or needs repairs. And we go ahead and add the first strand and then we go back over it again with a little bit of a zigzag line because we want to give it a twisted look on the wire. And we also want to add little bitty barbs on it because it's barbed wire. So go ahead and add little X shapes that make it look like there's little bitty barbs sticking out. We're going to go ahead and make this a three strand fence. So go ahead and add in the second strand here using the same technique. And we want this to use black paint probably or a really dark brown. Now, if you're following along traditionally, then you'll want to use your script brush for this. And you go ahead and make a really thin ink-like mixture with your paint. And then roll your long script brush up to a point and go ahead and lightly drag it over the canvas and make your wire lines here. And just use the same techniques, go back over it again with a zigzag line to make it look like it's twisted and go ahead and add the little bitty barbs on it as well. And just go ahead and make sure that they look like they've fallen into the grass here. Because that's the kind we just want to make it look like it's an old fence here, just for some aesthetics, some artistic look. It just, you know, people like to look at things that are kind of old and rugged looking. And then we need to go ahead and start on our wildflowers, and these are going to be the final layer of wildflowers, so we want to make these bigger. And if you're following along traditionally, your short script brush will work. And I'm going to use the Leo brush for the Infinite Painter brush. And we want to go ahead and just make some short, rough strokes in the shape of flower petals. We are not interested in being too detailed because they're in the grass and you're not going to see them real close up. So you just want kind of rough strokes on these flowers. And go ahead and give them just the impression of petals. And we want to go ahead and add them down in the corner and up around in the fence post. And we're using deoxyzine purple for the first ones. Now the second batch we can use cadmium yellow light. And we go ahead and use the same rough stroke techniques. Just give jagged little petal looks to each of your flowers, and we kind of want to put them in a Z shape here and put them behind the posts, around them. We kind of want them over the top of some of the purple ones. That gives it a three-dimensional look as well. Go ahead and put them in front of your posts, even on top of your wire. This all sets this back and makes it look like it's real grass and real wildflowers. And go ahead and make them in the zigzag pattern again, like we did with the small wildflowers, so that they're not in just big clumps. We kind of want them to look like they're growing in a natural pattern. and go ahead and add just a few more right there on the edge. And then we want to add in the little centers. So these kind of give the impression that they're kind of a daisy type flower or a black-eyed Susan. And I was using a really dark brown or almost a black. Or you can use burnt umber if you're following along traditionally. And just put a little dot in the center. It doesn't have to be in the exact center. We're not looking for a perfect looking flower. We just kind of want to give the impression of there's a bunch of wildflowers and they're all different directions in the grass. Then we want to go ahead and set these flowers into the grass. So let's go ahead and get some phthalo yellow green and add highlights to the grass here. And we're going to be using the same technique that we did in the last video, which is sort of a half round circle oval stroke. And I'm using the Chanel brush on Infinite Painter just to give a very thin line. And you can use your long script brush with the ink like paint mixture and just go ahead and put some of these strands over the top of your big flowers. Put some of these strands over the top of your barbed wire. Go ahead and add some more darker green there, some Hooker's green or a sage green color, and go ahead and add it on the bottoms of your fence posts, add it on the top of the wire. Make sure it goes over your big wildflowers because we want this to look three-dimensional and we want everything to look like it's in the middle of the grass here. And just go ahead and add these as the final touches, just wherever you think that there needs to be a few more grass strands, and pull them up over the top of the fence post just to make it look set down into the grass. Okay, and then here's my signature, and a lot of times I will pick a color that's already in the painting just so it's not so jarring. I mean, that's just my personal preference. Some people just sign in red, which is fine, but I just like to use a color that I've already used in the painting just so it matches a little bit. So here is our old fence post painting. And you can go ahead and call this painting finished. The old fence posts are a perfect subject to just leave and make it look like an old rustic painting. But here are some of my past paintings, and here are some of the things that I've done in the past. I've changed the kind of fence that we have. I've added roosters sitting on it. I've added a butterfly on the other one. You can put butterflies. You can put any type of bird that you want. I've put these fence posts in other pictures. This is my farm painting, and I have a farm in the background. And also, I've got an old wagon wheeling up against the wall of the fence post and a bluebird. You can do whatever you want to, or you can just leave it like an old fence post. You can even put a fairy in there if you want to. It's just your personal preference on what you want to add to this painting at the end. Or, like I said, you can just leave it plain if you want to. This is a perfectly fine subject. Lots of people just like old fence posts. Thank you, everyone, for watching. If you have any questions, just go ahead and leave them down below in the comments, and I'll try my best to answer your questions. And stay tuned for a new painting. I will be working on a new Infinite Painter painting. And thank you so much for your support, and I'll catch you later.